यस्चन्दसाम् ऋषभो विश्वरूपः.
Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, Professor Shor of God, and I have brought a new topic with you in Prestressed Concrete, the subject which all civil engineers learn during their graduation or post-graduation courses all over India. Today, I have brought the topic of analysis of stresses in composite construction. Analysis of stresses in composite construction. In my last video lecture, you have seen that I have discussed about the basic introduction or the background behind the purpose of utilization of composite construction techniques and cast in situ concrete techniques in prestressed concrete design. I have also discussed in my previous lectures, I have also discussed design of prestressed concrete beams under flexure. I have also discussed the concepts of design of prestressing beam in accordance with IS 1343-1980. So, Fitz, welcome back. I hope everyone is studying very hard in their home and you are practicing very nicely. Today, if we see the last topic, it will be just a continuation of that topic only. Today we will take two consideration, two conditions in composite construction beams. We will take unpropped section and propped section and study their analysis of various stresses under dead load and even under live load. Let's start. As I discussed earlier, in composite construction, in composite construction, and cast in situ, in In composite construction and cast in situ, we have two conditions which we have to study while analyzing various stresses. In case one, we have unpropped precast prestress unit. Unpropped precast pre-stressing unit. So in this unpropped precast pre-stressing unit, what are the stresses which we have to study? The stresses which comes, obviously we all know beforehand that the stresses which come in this composite construction are nothing but the basic bending equations. The stresses which come due to the basic bending equations which we have learned in the very first chapter in pre-stressed concrete structure. There is nothing so much difference in the basic concepts. Now, in the self-weight, if we, not only self-weight, if we calculate the stresses to be computed, the stresses to be computed in unpropped precast unit, the stresses will be computed due to self-weight of composite section, self-weight of composite section will be nothing but the stresses due to self-weight of pre-stressed beam, self-weight due to pre-stressed beam. These things we earlier know if you have done the previous lecture video. If you have seen the previous lecture, we have discussed all these things. Today I will do a problem on these basic concepts. Stresses due to self-weight of pre-stressing beam plus due to pre-stressing force acting at an eccentricity at an specified eccentricity, all right, and again stresses due to self-weight of cast in situ concrete. Similarly, these are the stresses which we have calculated by considering the dead load only. Again, if we take about live load, this is one thing I talked about. If we take about live load, so the live load stresses will be computed by calculating the section modulus of the composite section. Right? So these are the things which we learn in unpropped precast pre-stressing unit. Now coming to case 2. In case 2, in which we have the prop section, here in this prop section, the stresses calculated, or we can write stresses computed, will be calculated using the section modulus of the whole structure, and the live load is taken as whole. So stresses computed will be using the section modulus of the whole composite section, first thing, and the second thing, the live load stresses will be calculated, whole together. will be calculated whole together. Okay. So this is the fundamental concept of analyzing pre-stressing stresses in prop section and unprop section. Now in prop section, in unprop section, we know the basic definition is that in unprop section, the whole section, the composite section, which is composed of precast pre-stressed unit and the cast in situ hardened concrete, they are supported only at the extreme ends of the beam or girder. In prop section, the whole beam section of composite will be supported throughout its length of the beam. That means total support hoga, the whole beam will be supported from its starting point till end point. Another difference in unpropped and propped section is that, please keep this in mind, in unpropped section, what happens if you take these two books as different sections? Let me take this as a rectangular section, or you may take T section, whatever. If first the precast pre-stressed beam will be casted, it may be in the site or it may be precast from the factories and placed at the construction site. The first stage will be the casting or the fabrication of pre-stressed section, and on top we will have, let us say, this orange book hai. So this orange book is, let us take as cast in situ concrete. So the first stage, the pre-stressing beam will be fabricated or placed, and on top of that the second stage will be casting on the pre-stressed beam, that is cast in situ concrete. So in unprop section, the dead load is increased. How? The dead load stress is increased because of this pre-stressed beam in first phase and this cast in situ beam in the second phase. In unpropped section, what we do? In prop section, the total casting of the beam is done monolithically. That means at the same time, we are casting for the pre-stressed beam. Also, we are casting for the cast in situ concrete. Right? So this top slab or deck slab will be taken as cast in situ hardened concrete section. And obviously, hum logo pata hai, we all know that this cast in situ concrete ranges from maybe 20 to 30 Newton per millimeter square, or M20 to M30 concrete, that is low to medium grade concrete. But for pre-tensioned precast beam, we are using grade of concrete above M30 or M40, so respectively for pre-tensioning and post-tensioning. So this is how we have to know the basic fundamental difference between the unpropped section and propped section. Okay. Now I will be showing you the variation of stresses in unprop section first, then I will compare with that of prop section. So let's start.
La 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 la. So after a long time, this is the thing.
ध्यान से देखना है, वेरी कीप योर कंसंट्रेशन एट हाईएस्ट पॉइंट. आई विल, देयर इज स्लाइट एंड वेरी स्लाइट डिफरेंस बिटवीन द स्ट्रेस वेरिएशन ऑफ अनप्रॉप सेक्शन एंड प्रॉप सेक्शन. ओके, सो कीप योर आईज फिक्स्ड ऑन माय बोर्ड Do not get deviated at every second in this lecture class.
Stress variation. Stress variation. Stress variation. So let us take, first of all, let me take a T section. Let us take the T section, the flange of the T section be the cast in situ concrete. So I am taking this top flange as the hardened cast in situ concrete. Cast in situ concrete, and here I am showing you, or I am representing the, this is the precast pretension unit. We have precast pretensioning unit with the cable profile or the anchorage area. If you make this T section a bit bigger, precast pre-stressing unit. Okay, so this is the precast pre-stressing unit, right? Similarly, let us now draw the diagram first. Everyone should very carefully draw the diagram, because the diagrams which are represented in any book, any Indian book, is not very proper. The stress diagram is not very proper given in any Indian books on pre-stress concrete. So we will start drawing the diagrams. So let us take the first diagram. First, I will draw the diagrams, then I will explain one by one. Let me take this as unpropped section. Unpropped. And similarly, let me take one propped section. Okay, one unpropped, and let me take this is propped section. The dimensions of unpropped and propped sections are not very different. They are similar. They are absolutely similar. So let me draw this diagram. These are the extreme fiber end diagram, or the axis of extreme fiber ends. Okay, right? So now let us draw the diagram. So in the above portion we have the unpropped section, and the below diagram we have propped section. So the first diagram will be like this. As I told you, first I will, so in this diagrams, we will follow the conventions positive will be tension. We will represent the positive zone of the stresses as tension and the negative as compression. We will take the negative as compression. Okay. So the first diagram you may feel to shade the stresses, no problem. First I will draw the diagram, then I will explain it. Okay. So first, properly take down the diagrams. So this is the stress variation. These are the stress variation in unpropped section and propped section. Now if you see properly, first I will show you the diagrams. Now, let me represent first this diagram A. Let me represent first this diagram A. I am demarcating the diagrams and I will write at the top one by one. So the diagram first, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have overall 5 stress diagrams for prop section and again 5 stress diagrams for unpropped section. Now in which stage they are varying and why they are varying, I will explain one by one. So in the first diagram, let me define A, B, C, D and E, F. Similarly, let me represent E and F. Okay. So the fashion of or the formation of stresses in prop section as well as in unprop section are will be varied, will be different. So let me first show them. Okay, if you see the first diagram, the first stress diagram will be the initial pre-stress. The first stress diagram will be initial pre-stress. initial pre-stress diagram, which will be nothing but corresponding to PI.
The initial pre-stress diagram, when we will, after this we will do one problem. So the initial stress diagram will be nothing but the initial pre-stress, that is PI, initial pre-stressing force, how we are getting, or the pre-stressing force will be given in our problems. Or problem statement, the initial pre-stress will be mentioned.
The second diagram B is nothing but the effective pre-stress. The second diagram B is the stress, this B is nothing but the stress due to effective pre-stress that we can calculate as PE after losses. After losses.
Pardon for a minute. Kali bharna hai. Okay, so the A diagram is the initial pre-stress, B diagram is the effective pre-stress, which will calculate after the pre-stress losses,
after the pre-stress losses. Now the diagram C, the stress diagram C, the stress diagram C, this one, the stress diagram C is self-fed stress, the self-fed stress, everyone write down. The self-fed stress due to precast member, due to pre-stressed precast beam, pre-stressed precast beam, or you can write precast pre-stressed member, right?
I will explain you the difference by and by. First, let us label the diagrams. The diagram C is nothing but the stress due to the self-fed stress of the precast pre-stressing unit. The figure D, coming to figure D, is nothing but the self-fed stress due to cast in situ concrete. Cast in situ concrete. The self-fed stress due to this figure D. This figure D is nothing but the cast in situ concrete. And figure E, this figure, this and this, they are similar. This, if you can just, we will have a comparison between them. Okay. Now, the stress E is due to the live load stresses. The stress E is due to the live load stresses. Stress number E is due to the live load stresses. Now, if you can see properly this diagram and this diagram, these two diagrams are similar. Now, in unprop section, now see in this case, in these two diagrams, that is, in unprop section, the stress diagram due to the precast member and the stress diagram due to the self-weight of the cast in situ concrete, they will be similar. This we will calculate in this diagram C. We will calculate the dead load due to the precast member. Similarly, calculating the dead load, we will calculate the bending moment of the dead load of precast beam. And similarly, we will calculate the stresses at top and bottom. How? We will compute the stresses by the dead load bending moment divided by the section modulus. Similarly, here also, that is C and D, they have the lever arm or they have the neutral axis at the same distance. But in unpropped section, in prop section, if we come to prop section, the graph C, the self-weight stress due to pre-stressing member will be same as unpropped, but in D, so this is the basic difference, that in this diagram C and D, in diagram C and D, there is a basic difference between prop section and unprop section. Okay, so in diagram C and D, we don't need the to calculate the section modulus of total composite section. But in prop section, starting from the D figure, we need to calculate the section modulus of the total composite section. Okay. Now we will start with one problem. One problem is there. We will do that problem step. Okay. Very simple problem. Questions bahut easy hai. So don't have to worry about the questions in this module. So the question tells that, the question is saying that, first listen, then I will make the write down. A precast pretension beam of rectangular section has a breadth. Precast pretension beam. So we will now start with our problem. Hashtag problem. Abhi hashtag ka zamana aa gaya. So hashtag karna hai. So hashtag problem kya hai? It is given that precast pretension beam diya hai. It is given that precast pretension beam is given of rectangular section. Beam ka section diya hua hai, rectangular section. So we have the breadth B equals to 100 mm. It is given, the breadth given as 100 mm, depth as 200 mm. So understand? So precast pre-stressed beam mein kya diya hai? Breadth diya hua hai aur depth diya hua hai. Okay? Now it is also given the beam with effective span of 5 meter. Effective span
obviously that means span length. Effective span length is given 5 meter. Effective span is given 5 meter. Okay. And it is also mentioned, it is pre-stressed by tendons with their centroids coincide with the bottom kern. So it is pre-stressed. So right, see, I am writing the statement in a very point-wise manner. Okay. It is pre-stressed. It is pre-stressed by tendons, which is coinciding tendons, which coincides with the bottom kern. Coincides with bottom kern. Bottom kern meaning the bottom edge. That means at this edge. So we have, see in this diagram, we have the pre-stressing coinciding with the bottom kern. Next, what is written? It is written that the initial pre-stressing force P is given as, PI is given as 150 kN. PI is given 150 kN. The loss is given as, loss of pre-stress is given as 15%. The loss is given as 15%, 15. Again it is mentioned, the beam is incorporated in a composite T-beam. The precast beam, kya hai? It is incorporated, matlab andar ghus gaya. It has entered inside some matter. Incorporated into a composite T-beam. Right? T-beam of, kya hai? We have top flange, composite T-beam of top flange 400 mm wide, and we have the depth or thickness as 40 mm. So we have the precast beam is inserted into the composite T-beam mein ye ghus gaya, aur T-beam ka total top flange ka width hai 400 aur thickness hai 40. Now it is written, if the composite beam supports a live load of 8 kN, that is the composite T-beam, ye bhi likh lo, everyone write down, the composite T-beam supports what? The composite T-beam supports live load of 8 kN per meter. The T-beam supports a live load of 8 kN per meter. Now we have to calculate the resultant stresses. Calculate resultant stresses. We have to calculate resultant stresses in two conditions. Jaise maine sikhaya, the way I have taught you, we have to calculate the resultant stresses in two stages. First is unpropped section or unpropped condition, whatever you call, in case of unpropped condition, and second is propped condition. So mere pyare bachcho, my students, give as much as likes in you can in the video. Bahut 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 likes chahiye. I need more subscribe, and in comment section you give me some questions, you ask me some questions, any doubts. And if you need video lectures
on any topics, if you need video lectures on any topics in any subject regarding all the subjects in structural engineering, since I am based from structural engineering expertise, any subjects, any topics, it may be strength of materials, it may be estimation and costing, it may be RCC design, it may be steel design, it may be pre-stressed concrete, it may be earthquake engineering, any topic you want the video lectures, you just write it in the subscribe, turant I will create a video on that lecture topic, okay? So I want more and more likes, more and more subscribers in my video. So I have started my video channel, so at home you can enjoy my video lectures anywhere, anytime, okay? So more and more subscribes chahiye, minimum 10,000 subscribers chahiye, target hai. So coming back to the question, mazak ho gaya, coming back to the question, calculate resultant stresses in unprop condition and prop condition. To kya diya hua hai, normal precast jo beam tha, precast beam ka depth hai 200 mm, width hai 100 mm, or total when it is inserted in T-beam, the T-beam has 440. So let's begin with the problem. So, the thing is like this. First, I will draw the diagram and then I will calculate various parameters which we will require. Solution. I am mentioning you this type of questions you will get in any examination, in wherever institute you are studying, jo institute mein tum pad rahe ho, it doesn't matter, it may be IIT, it may be NIT, it may be any private institute, private universities, whenever you are being taught this pre-stressed concrete structure, and if you have these module topics, these type of basic concepts, basic questions and long questions will be given from the problems which I am discussing. Okay, so the solution, obviously first I will draw the diagram. So diagram aise banega, this is the total composite concrete beam, okay, the total composite concrete beam, and as it has been mentioned in the question, the T beam has flange width of 400 mm and depth of 40 mm, and this rectangular section we have 100 mm and 200 mm depth. So we have for this T section, if you have T section here, then what we are having? We are having this T section 400 by 40 and this rectangular section which is precast 100 by 200 mm dimension. Okay. So the first step one, first we have to concentrate on this one. First we have to concentrate on this precast member. First we have to concentrate on this precast member. So the step one will be calculate, let us check out section properties of precast members. Section properties of precast members. Bachcho, achhe se padhai karo. in wherever institute you are teaching, or in whichever institute you are learning or studying, this pre-stress concrete structure, agar mere video lectures, agar achhe se, if you go through all the lectures, from the first lecture till the last lecture, you can easily score very, very, very good marks in your pre-stressed concrete subject. Okay?
So, section board of precast member, obviously, we have to carry first calculate the area. Area, so we are only concerned with this part. We are only concerned with this rectangular section. So, area will be 100 into 200. So, it will be 2 into 10 to the power 4 mm square. Area will be 2 into 10 to the power 4 mm square. Then after calculating area, we will calculate Z, that is the section modulus. Section modulus for rectangular section is same for top and bottom. For top and bottom, we know that the section modulus for only this rectangular section will be different. But when we will calculate the section modulus for the whole system, then we have to calculate the जो जैसे मैंने स्ट्रेस डायग्राम में दिखाया, when we have to calculate the section modulus for the whole composite T section, then we have to calculate the YT. YT is nothing but the distance of the centroidal distance from the top fiber. Then we have to calculate YT, then YB from bottom fiber, and we have to calculate the section modulus at top ZT and at bottom ZB. Now in examination, as a question, it may be I section, it may be given. Please mark my words, please mark my lecture, that यहाँ पे T section maximum ज्यादातर पे T sections आता है. If T section is not given, I section will be given for you. The section modulus for ZT, so coming to rectangular section, we have BD square by 6. We know everyone. So BD square by 6. So calculating this BD square by 6, and we are getting the section modulus of 667 into 10 to the power 3 mm cube. So the section modulus is given 667 multiplied 10 to the power 3 mm cube. Right? So now, so we have got the section modulus. Now we have the step 1. The pre-stressing force is given what? Pre-stressing force PI, that is the initial one, is given as 150 kN. Right? 150 kN. Now we have to calculate the stress due to pre-stress. You may write case 1 will be calculation of initial pre-stress. ध्यान देना है बच्चों, कोई गलती नहीं होगा, कोई गलती होना भी नहीं चाहिए, समझे? So calculation of initial pre-stress. So we will calculate the stresses first. Let me take F. Okay. F the stresses. Okay. So we know 2P by area. 2P by A. So 2P will be PI. So 2 into 150 into 10 to the power 3 divided by the area. 2 into 10 to the power 4. So we have 2 into 150 into 10 to the power 3 divided by 2 multiplied with 10 to the power 4, that is the area. So we are getting the stress as 15 newton per millimeter square. So this will be stress at bottom, while stress at top is 0. Stress at top is 0, right? Because it is in composite section. So stress at top is 0. Right, so we have the initial stresses. So therefore, we can write initial pre-stress, only not pre-stressing force. Pre-stress FB as 15, that is plus 15 Newton per millimeter square. Right? Based on this value, हम लोग का जो डायग्राम होगा स्ट्रेस डायग्राम होगा दैट विल वैल्यू. नेक्स्ट इफेक्टिव प्री स्ट्रेस विल बी नथिंग बट हाउ मच गिवन लॉस रेशियो वाज गिवन एस लॉस कितना परसेंटेज दिया था लॉस हम लोग को दिया गया था 15% लॉस हम लोग को दिया गया था. सो वी विल टेक 0.85 लॉस रेशियो. सो देयरफॉर आवर लॉस रेशियो विल बी 0.85. राइट. सो 0.85 इनटू 15 वी आर गेटिंग द वैल्यू अबाउट 12.8 न्यूटन पर मिलीमीटर स्क्वायर प्लस. सो ऑब्वियसली दिस विल बी एट द बॉटम. सो FB. So this will be at the bottom, FB. Right? So in the first step, we have calculated the area of the section. We have calculated section modulus. यहाँ पे moment of inertia निकाल अगर निकाल सकते हो, if possible you can calculate the moment of inertia I, that is BD cube by 12, and that. Section modulus it will be d by 2. So directly we are using the formula bd square by 6. So from this we are getting the section modulus. From section modulus we are calculating the pre-stressing force. Now section modulus till now we have not used. We will use it when we will calculate the stresses due to self-weight of precast member, that is figure C, and stresses due to cast in situ concrete, that is figure D, in unpropped section. ठीक है? तो चलो. Okay, so this is the, so we have calculated the initial pre-stress and we have calculated the effective pre-stress. Now, okay, so now may I, so this is the first thing जो तुम लोग को करना है, which you have to do. Take down this one. पॉज करके वीडियो लिख लेना. ओके. नाउ वी हैव टू स्टेप टू. डिजाइन के स्टेप्स में इन आरसीसी सब्जेक्ट इन द डिजाइन ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट रिइंफोर्स कॉन्क्रीट in design of steel structures and in design of pre-stressed concrete structure, agar stepwise hum log kar sakte hain, that is the best possible way to solve any long question. Aise long questions normally board exam mein to aata hi hai, university examinations, we have college examinations, in all the universities all over India we have these type of questions, and also in IES, or which we call now as EEC, इंजीनियरिंग सर्विस एग्जामिनेशन जो पेपर टू है वो है थ्योरेटिकल लॉन्ग क्वेश्चन, उसमें ऐसे क्वेश्चन दिया जाता है. एंड ऑल्सो एस एस सी जेई में पेपर टू में दिया जाता है. सो स्टेप टू विल बी कैलकुलेशन ऑफ स्ट्रेसेस due to self-weight of precast member, due to self-weight of precast member. ठीक है. See. So obviously to calculate the stress, what we need? P by, obviously we know that. दो formula होता है stress का, एक होता है P by area और होता है M by Z, right? M by Z हम लोग को मालूम है, that is bending moment divided by section modulus. So we have to first calculate the self weight. Self weight of the precast or pre-stressed member. So let us take as dead load Mg. So Mg is what? Sorry, not Mg. First we will write G only. G, that is the dead load. So we know the area. So we will calculate the volume. 0.1 into 0.2 into 24. That is area multiplied with the unit weight of PCC. Here we are using, always remember, pre-stressed concrete may always we take the unit weight of plain cement concrete, that is PCC, as 24 kilonewton per meter cube. Kuch books mein galat diya hua hai. Bachcho, dhyan se suno. Kuch books mein galat diya hua hai. It is given wrongly in some books. It is given wrongly in some books, in many of Indian books which I have found. Usme diya hai 25. They have given 25 kilonewton per meter cube. But actually, to be correct, we should use PCC. We should not use PCC. We should use PCC until and unless if it is mentioned that pre-stressed beam is there along with RCC, along with steel rebar, along with reinforcement. Tab hum log use karenge 25. Jaise ki RCC design mein, in RCC design subject, sare jagah pe jahan pe hum log dead weight calculate karte hain, we use 25, that is unit weight of RCC member. But in pre-stressed concrete members, we will always use the unit weight of plain cement concrete, PCC. Okay? So this is coming as 480 newton per meter. 480 newton per meter. If I make it into newton. Okay? Now, self weight moment. Self-weight moment due to pre-stressing member these type of questions you can inadvertently expect 10 marks to 12 marks 10 marks to 12 marks question aise aa sakta hai. We have Mg. So we know that W square by 8, GL square by 8. So we will take 480. We have span length 5 by 8. That is, we have got 1500 newton meter. So obviously W square by 8, W can take G. I told you earlier, dead load as per Krishna Raju book, we represent dead load as G. So this is the moment. So similarly, we will calculate stresses. Stresses due to self weight. Stresses due to self weight of the pre-stressed member. Stresses due to pre-stressed member. We have the one section modulus, so it will be same. Ft or Fb will be equals to plus minus Mg by Z. We know, so it will be 1500. So we will calculate the stress section modulus. So, यहाँ पे Q 10 to the power 3 किये, I have converted in 10 to the power 3 to convert newton meter to newton millimeter. So, my value is, I am getting 2.25 newton per millimeter square. Newton per millimeter square. That is the calculation of self weight of precast member. उसके साथ और एक लिख दो cast in situ concrete. Cast in situ concrete. दोनों ही एक साथ कर लेते because they are almost similar. The way of calculation is similar. So we have got stress at top, stress at bottom, mu by z, that is 2.25. Again for we have for cast in situ concrete. So in this first stage we have calculated the precast member, we have calculated. So in second case we will calculate the cast in situ concrete, right? So for cast in situ concrete, for cast in situ concrete, same steps. First calculate the dead load due to cast in situ. Dead load due to cast in situ concrete. Right? So kya hoga dead load? So this is the cast in situ, CI. Cast in situ. So we will take the dimensions. So 400 mm 0.4 and 40 mm 0.04 multiplied with 24. So we are getting as 384 multiplied with 10 to the power 3 millimeter. Sorry, dead load. Sorry, 384 10 to the power 3 newton meter. Okay, so self weight we are getting 384 10 to the power 3. Just check me per meter. Sorry, it is UDL, so obviously load per meter, right? So now mg due to cast in situ concrete, that is mg will be nothing but gl square 384 into 10 to the power 3 mg by. So we have W square by 8. Again we have W square by 8, that is 1200 newton meter, and calculate the stresses. Stresses due to self weight of cast in situ concrete. Self weight of cast in situ concrete, that is nothing but mg plus minus mg by z. Again the same section modulus we will use. So 1200, same concept, 1200. It was 3, same section modulus. We are getting about 1.8 newton per millimeter. We are getting the stresses as 1.8 plus minus meaning plus 1.8 at the top fiber and minus 1.8 at the bottom fiber. Okay. So this will be step 2. So step 2, we will be calculating for figure C and D. Dimag mein thaan lo, C or D diagrams ke liye hum log ye nikale. Stresses due to the self weight for precast member and stresses due to the cast in situ concrete. Now coming to third step. My dear students, if you are feeling funny, if you are feeling excited about my classes, please do inform me in the comment section below. Do mention that if you are feeling excited, if you are feeling interested in my classes, do mention those in the comment section below. इसीलिए मेरा उत्साह और भी बढ़ता है, उत्साह और भी बढ़ता है बस तुम लोग को सिखाने के लिए. मेरे प्यारे बच्चों, ऑल ओवर इंडिया से ये वीडियो देख रहे हो, तो डोंट फॉरगेट टू कमेंट मी एनी टॉपिक्स, एनी डाउट्स, एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स. यू जस्ट मेल मी, I will give the email ID in the comment section below. Just mail me or write in the comment section below. Now step 3 is nothing but to calculate the stresses, calculation of stresses. Calculation of stresses due to live load. Before that, calculation of stresses due to live load. उससे पहले, yes, to live load. ठीक है, okay. Now under this, there will be two subparts. A. Section properties. क्या है सेक्शन प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द टोटल कॉम्पोजिट सेक्शन. अभी टाइम क्या आया है, नाउ इट इज टाइम टू कंसीडर द होल स्ट्रक्चर. अभी टाइम आ गया है टोटल स्ट्रक्चर को एज अ कॉम्पोजिट सेक्शन मानने के लिए. मगर मींस द टोटल सेक्शन, द टॉप फ्लैंज एंड द बॉटम रेक्टेंगुलर, इट मे बी कॉल्ड एज वेब. नाउ इट विल एक्ट एज अ टोटल मोनोलिथिक और वन सिस्टम स्ट्रक्चर. मोनोलिथिक मतलब, मोनोलिथिक मींस वन सिस्टम स्ट्रक्चर. सो सेक्शन प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द टोटल कॉम्पोजिट सेक्शन. सेक्शन प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द टोटल कॉम्पोजिट सेक्शन क्या है इसमें. फर्स्ट वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट सो टोटल. तो फर्स्ट वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट द वाई टी, दैट इज द डिस्टेंस ऑफ द लीवर आर्म, सॉरी न्यूट्रल एक्सिस, डिस्टेंस ऑफ द न्यूट्रल एक्सिस, डिस्टेंस ऑफ द सेंट्रोइडल न्यूट्रल एक्सिस फ्रॉम extreme top fiber, from extreme top fiber. क्या है ये, yt is distance of the centroid neutral axis from extreme top fiber, or we can directly write distance of the neutral axis from our top fiber. yt हो गया top, yb will be from the bottom, right? So we will calculate all these things, distance of the centroidal neutral axis from the extreme bottom fiber. Dono hum log ko nikalna hai, bottom fiber, okay. So yt we know, a1 y1 plus, we know the same old formula. Dekho bachcho, ye jo formula hai, this formula to calculate the centroidal axis distance of any section comprising of more than one figure, this we have learnt in second year onwards. In many colleges and many institutes we learn from first year onwards, but mainly when you enter into the civil engineering subjects, this formula we have learnt from the strength of material subject in second year only. So nothing I have to explain on this thing, just follow. एरिया फोर, सो पहले एरिया ए वन ए टू मान लेते हैं, ये मान लो एरिया ए वन, ये मान लो एरिया ए टू. सो 400 इंटू 40 इंटू 20 प्लस 100 इंटू 200 इंटू 140 डिवाइडेड बाई ए वन ए टू. तो पहला होगा दिस वन इज एरिया ए वन, प्लस ए टू, एंड वी आर गेटिंग वैल्यू ऑफ 87 mm एज वाई टी. वी आर गेटिंग 87 mm एज वाई टी, एंड वाई बी वी विल गेट दैट इज 240 माइनस वाई टी. We are getting YB as 153. We are getting YB as 143 for YB and 187 mm for YT. So YT is the centroidal distance from the top fiber and YB is the centroidal distance from the bottom fiber, right? Now why we are calculating all these things? Because students, after this, मैं क्या calculate करूंगा बच्चों? I will calculate moment of inertia. इसके बाद that means y निकल गया, centroidal axis निकल गया. उसके बाद I will calculate the moment of inertia. And we know that section modulus. After that, I will calculate moment of inertia, xi. And after that, we know that section modulus is I by y. Right or wrong, section modulus is I by Y, which comes from bending equation, in which we learned in strength of material subject in second year. So top ke liye alag hoga, bottom ke liye alag hoga. Isiliye I have calculated YT, I have calculated YB. Okay, my students, so let's start. So now calculation, moment of inertia or second area of moment, कुछ भी कहो, मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया और हम लोग बोलते हैं सेकेंड मोमेंट ऑफ एरिया. सेकेंड मोमेंट ऑफ एरिया बोथ आर सेम. सो वी विल यूज हियर, वी विल प्रैक्टिकली यूज, बट देयर आर टू फॉर्म्स, देयर आर टू मेथड्स यहां पे. वन इज परपेंडिकुलर एक्सिस थ्योरम और दूसरा है पैरेलल एक्सिस थ्योरम. मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया या सेकेंड मोमेंट ऑफ एरिया निकालने के लिए दोनों फॉर्मूला हम लोग को पता है. वन वी यूज, वी कैन यूज परपेंडिकुलर एक्सिस थ्योरम, एंड सेकेंड इज वी नो पैरेलल एक्सिस थ्योरम, राइट? सो हियर वी विल यूज पैरेलल एक्सिस थ्योरम. फर्स्ट वी विल बी टेकिंग फॉर एरिया ए वन. ध्यान से बच्चों देख लो, दिस प्लस दिस द फर्स्ट फिगर प्लस सेकेंड फिगर के लिए. सो 1/12 बी डी क्यू प्लस ए इंटू वाई बार स्क्वायर. और बेसिक इक्वेशन इज बेसिक इक्वेशन इज वी ऑल नो बाय पैरेलल एक्सिस थ्योरम आई वाई वाई इज नथिंग बट आई सॉरी आई एक्स वाई इज नथिंग बट आई वाई वाई प्लस ए इंटू वाई बार स्क्वायर. पता है ना हम लोग को ए इंटू वाई बार स्क्वायर. सो दिस टोटल वैल्यू इज कमिंग एज आई इज कमिंग एज 1968 0.04 into 10 to the power 5 millimeter to the power 4. So this total value, this total value of moment of inertia I is coming this value. Everyone please listen to my students, this value of I is coming as 1968.04 × 10⁴ mm⁴. अगर बच्चों दिस मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया में कैलकुलेशन करने के लिए दिक्कत आ रहा है, इफ यू आर फाइंडिंग सम प्रॉब्लम्स इन दिस हाउ टू कैलकुलेट मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया, प्लीज मेंशन सर एक अलग क्लास चाहिए, एक अलग वीडियो लेक्चर चाहिए, कमेंट सेक्शन में डाल दो। ऑब्वियसली आई विल क्रिएट वन लेक्चर वीडियो ऑन मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया कैलकुलेशन। ओके, सो वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड the yt, yb and moment of inertia. So we directly we can easily find out section modulus. We can easily calculate section modulus. Video pause करके सारे board work निचोड़ लो. Okay? I will not waste time on waiting. Pause the video and take down the notes. So section modulus at top is at t. So I by yt we know. So calculation kar lo. 1968. We are taking a whole number, no problem. Divided by yt. 87. So yahan pe automatically turant section modulus at top or section modulus at bottom calculate kar lo. It is coming 226.2 × 10⁴ mm³ and ZB is coming I by YB, that is 1968 × 10⁵ / 153. It is coming 128.63 × 10⁴ mm³. So we have calculated ZT and ZP, जो हम लोग के लिए ब्रह्मास्त्र है अर्जुन का ब्रह्मास्त्र। सो ये दीज आर ऑल लाइक ब्रह्मास्त्र। सो ZP एंड ZP वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड, सो वी कैन कैलकुलेटेड ZT एंड ZB इजीली, राइट। नाउ आवर कैलकुलेशन ऑफ डेड लोड, लाइव लोड। सो ZT ZB निकल गया, नाउ वी कैन focus on calculation of live load. So live load acting on this one, this live load is acting. So as I say, live load, you can see we have this section as a live load, okay, which also represents Q. So live load acting on top slab which is cast in situ concrete, right. So this just calculate. So 0.4 into 1 meter into 8000 is coming as 3200 newton per meter. So live load we have calculated Q, 3200 number meters. So MQ we will calculate here. Q is curve 8. Same formula, koi alag nahi hai. So it is coming as 10⁷ newton millimeter. So it's coming as 10⁷ newton millimeter. So therefore, we can calculate the stresses based on live load. So here in this case, if you see properly, we have calculated first what we did. First we did the YT, YB calculation, then moment of inertia, then ZT and ZB based on moment of inertia and YT, YB. We have calculated, maan liye. Now, abhi hum log calculate kar liye live load and we have calculated the moment due to live load, right? Now we calculate stresses due to live load. Stresses due to live load. Live load, that is nothing but MQ by ZT, 10⁷ divided by ZT, 226 into 2. So just we are now just putting the values here, and we are getting these values. So this is nothing but FT. So stress due to that in the bottom section, MQ by ZB. ZB here 128.63 into 10^4, that is coming as minus 7.77 Newton per millimeter square. So we have calculated the stresses at top and at bottom due to lag. So we have calculated, if you see properly, we have calculated the stresses at top and bottom due to live load. Ye hai tum log ka figure E, propped, unpropped section ke liye. Till now we haven't done for propped. Propped ke liye abhi till we have not done. We are continuing for unpropped section. So stresses due to live load at top and bottom we have calculated. This will be put in diagram number E diagram. Okay, right. Now we will calculate if it is. ठीक है तो यहाँ तक total we have calculated for unpropped section and we will use for resultant stress calculation. Next for next for our if the beam is propped, write down if the composite section is propped, section is propped condition is propped, if the composite section is propped, then what will happen? The self weight of the slab will also act, self weight of slab for that is cast in situ concrete, the self weight of slab that is cast in situ will also act on the composite section as a whole. Matlab, if you take, that means the self weight of the top slab, maan lo agar fir se ye dono book aa gaya, maan lo ye pre-stress beam hai aur ye top slab hai, maan lo ye top slab hai, okay. Ab ye top slab mein, on this top slab what I am taking, the whole section is propped, meaning maine kya bola, what I told you, that will be the total section. That means in at same stage the casting for top slab, deck slab, as well as casting for pre-stressed concrete will take place. So obviously the dead weight, that one, if you remember the figure, now we will calculate for figure F D. For figure D in prop condition. Panne ulta lo, turn the pages, see that figure D. D mein agar dekhoge, to kya hai? The stresses due to dead load of cast in situ concrete, wo alag hai. So, on this, we have the slab, deck slab. Ab deck slab ka jo dead load hai, wo total structure mein padega. Okay? So, the total dead weight of the slab will come on the composite section. Okay, so we knew the moment due to self weight of slab, the moment due to self weight of slab was our 1200 Newton meter. which is nothing but mg slab, right? mg slab matlab dead load, that is dead load moment, or slab ke liye. So maan lo at top, so at top ft we calculate mg for slab. Now what we will use, we will use section at top, we will use section modulus at top, ZT. Now use it and find out the value. So we have 1200 into 10 to the power 3, ZT same 226. This is the only difference between your propped and unpropped and prop condition state. And at bottom, if B that is same, we will take mg, that is the dead load moment of the slab, divided by section modulus, क्लास भी खत्म हो जा रहा है और काली भी खत्म हो जा रहा है, ये है ना मजा बच्चों, अगर मजा नहीं आ रहा है तो नहीं हो पाएगा, मजा आना चाहिए, समझे? So these are, so हम लोग को ये स्ट्रेस एट टॉप एंड स्ट्रेस एट बॉटम ड्यू टू डेड वेट इन प्रॉप कंडीशन में निकाल गया. अब सारे वैल्यूज हम लोग को पता है, बस वैल्यूज लिख दो, काम खत्म. जो वैल्यूज लिख दो, काम खत्म. ओके, सो पॉज करके यू जस्ट टेक द नोट्स. ओके, so variation of stresses, first unpropped condition, unpropped और propped दोनों एक साथ हम लोग कर लेंगे. Just I am representing these are different, that is one is for cast in situ and precast. Properly you have to finally draw the diagram. So properly after calculation, after the complete calculation, it properly draw the variation of stresses.
Okay. So, गाड़ी चालू करते हैं आखिरी सफर के लिए.
ये आखिरी सफर. So, first we will represent initial stress. Figure 15. Effective pre-stress. So, just जो जो values निकला है, we just put this. Nothing is there.
So these are the stress values for, let me show the diagram. This is the value. So this is the value, first thing, this is the value for the initial pre-stress. The A diagram I told you, this is the stress diagram for initial pre-stress. The second is the effective pre-stress, defective pre-stress value, right? Defective pre-stress value. Next diagram is the stress due to the. Next diagram is the diagram C is the stress due to the sulfate of precast beam. Then similarly, stress due to sulfate of cast in situ concrete. And then the live load stresses. Then the figure E is the live load stresses. Okay. We have to also show the YT. Okay, and the last diagram is the resultant diagram. Last diagram is the resultant diagram. This is for the propped section. Similarly, so this we have done for the unpropped section. Sorry. So for propped section also, these the few things will be absolutely similar. Till the diagram C, the diagrams same over.
from diagram D has a change order. If you see properly, agar dhang se dekha jaye, if you see properly, the figure E, if you check the P, C, D, E, F. If you check the figure E, that is the stress variation due to live load on the composite section for propped as well as for unpropped, both are same. Both are same. So, if you properly see, the initial pre-stress value is same. The effective pre-stress value is also same. Even the self-weight stress due to precast beam is same. So, in the diagram, this will be the complete diagram of stress variation for unpropped and propped section, where you have to explicitly positively represent all the diagram with values, and also have to show the lever arm or the distance of the neutral axis for all the stress diagrams, where in the compression zone we are having positive sign, and from positive sign sign changes to 0 to negative, that is the tension zone. You have to show the lever arm distance of each and every diagram where the variation is occurring. So properly take this down. So thank you my students. बहुत क्लास कर लिया आज. वी हैव लर्नड अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स हियर. गिव एज मच एज कमेंट्स, सब्सक्राइब मोर एंड मोर दिस वीडियो. इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो आई विल बी कमिंग विथ माई लेक्चर क्लास. द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर विल बी ऑन स्टैटिकली इंटरमीडिएट स्ट्रक्चर्स एंड कॉन्टिन्यूअस बीम्स इन प्रीस्ट्रेस्ड कॉन्क्रीट. थैंक यू. I'm so lonely, broken.